Welcome to new session of nervous tissue. What is nervous tissue? These type of tissues are found in nervous system. Such tissues is known as nervous tissue. Okay, what is their function? Let us see. The nervous tissue is highly specialized to conduct impulses from one part of the body to another. Okay, so nervous tissue is highly specialized to conduct impulses from one part of the body to another. What are the subdivisions of nervous tissue? Let us see. It is divided into three main parts: central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, and autonomic nervous system. In central nervous system, we know that the brain and the spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system, it includes the nerves that comes under the cranial and the spinal. Then sensory and autonomic ganglia. Then autonomic nervous system, it is divided into sympathetic and parasympathetic. That is the secretomotor pathway and vasomotor. Okay, so how the subdivisions of nervous tissue is done? That two anatomical subdivision: central nervous system, peripheral nervous system, and autonomic nervous system. The central nervous system, it consists of our brain and spinal cord. Peripheral nervous system, it includes the cranial and spinal nerves. Then sensory and autonomic ganglia. Autonomic nervous system, it includes the sympathetic and parasympathetic system. Okay, let us see the cells of nervous tissue. We know that the neurons are the structural and functional unit of the nervous system. Then there are supportive cells. It is known as neuroglia, which provide metabolic and structural support for neurons, myelin sheath for homeostasis and phagocytic function. So the supportive cells is known as neuroglia. The structural and functional units of the nervous system is known as neurons. So what is the function of the neuroglia? It provide metabolic and structural support for neurons, insulation, homeostasis, and phagocytic function. Is it clear? So, which are the cells of nervous tissue? Neurons and supportive cells, that is the neuroglia. Let us see the structure of the neuron. It consists of cell body, processes, dendrites, and axon. Here you can see the picture of the neuron. You can see the dendrites, nucleus, axon hillock, neurolemma, then myelin sheath and nodes of the Ranvier. This all forms the neuron. Okay. While coming to the cell body. In the cell body, you can see the nucleus. How the nucleus is? It is large, spherical, centrally located. And they are having prominent nucleolus. Then well-developed cytoskeleton. That is the microtubules and the microfilaments. You can see the nasal substance, well-developed Golgi apparatus and mitochondria in the cytoplasm. Okay, so the cell body, it is having the nucleus, which is centrally located in the cell body, and prominent nucleolus. The cytoplasm, it is having well-developed cytoskeleton or the neurofibrils. Okay, then the nasal substance, well-developed Golgi apparatus and numerous mitochondria. Then while coming to the dendrites, they are usually multiple and highly branched. They possess spines to increase the surface area for synaptic contact. So what is the function then? It conducts impulses towards the cell body. Nasal substance is present. Okay, so you can see the dendrites as multiple and they are highly branched. Okay, look at this diagram. You can see the dendrites. How the dendrites are? It is branched. Okay, so the dendrites are branched. Then they are multiple. They possess spines to increase the surface area for the synaptic contact. Then what will be their function? Conduct impulses towards the cell body and the nasal substance is present. Next, while coming to the axon, you can usually see that one per neuron. They are longer than dendrites, but they lack sessile substance. What is the function of the axon? They transmit impulses away from the cell body to the neurons and the structures like muscle and the glands. They are myelinated or non-myelinated. Okay, so in neuron you can see one per axon. They are longer than the dendrites, they lack sessile substance and they transmit impulses away from the cell body to the neurons and the structures like muscle and the glands. They are myelinated or non-myelinated. Then, what is axon hillock? The region of the cell body where the axon originate. There are no rough endoplasmic reticulum. They continue with the initial segment of the axon. Okay, so the place where the cell body, the axon hillock, it is the region of the cell body where the axon originate. Rough endoplasmic reticulum is absent. It continues with the initial segment of the axon. Myelin sheath. How the myelin sheath is formed? Myelin sheath is formed by the plasma membrane of Schwann cells. In the Schwann cells, in the peripheral nervous system, and the oligodendrocytes in the central nervous system. Okay, so the myelin sheath is formed by the plasma membrane of Schwann cells in the peripheral nervous system and oligodendrocytes in the central nervous system. The node of Ranvier, it is the specialized region of the axon between the myelin sheath. Then internode means single myelin segment. Outside the myelin sheath, the cytoplasm of Schwann cells form the neurolemmal sheath. Okay, so the myelin sheath, how it is formed? It is formed by the plasma membrane of Schwann cells in the peripheral nervous system and oligodendrocytes in the central nervous system. Then node of Ranvier means the specialized region of the axon between the myelin sheath. Internode, it is a single myelin segment. Outside the myelin sheath, the cytoplasm of the Schwann cells form the neurolemmal sheath. Next, while coming to the peripheral nerve, it contains collection of the axons. So the group of axon, it forms fasciculus, nerve fasciculus. So aggregation of the fasciculus forms nerve. So in yesterday's session, we already studied about the epimysium, endomysium, perimysium, that are all the connective tissue layer covers single muscle fiber, entire muscle fiber and fasciculus. Like that, the nervous tissue or the nerve fiber, it is covered by connective tissue layer. Okay, let us see the layers which is surrounded the each axon. The connective tissue layer around each axon is known as endoneurium. Around the fasciculus of the axon is the perineurium and around the peripheral nerve is the epineurium. Okay, so around each axon is known as the endoneurium. Fasciculus of axon, fasciculus means group of axon that forms the nervous fasciculus. It is surrounded by the perineurium and around the peripheral nerve it is the epineurium. Okay, is it clear? So the connective tissue around each axon, it is the endoneurium. Around a fasciculus of axon is perineurium and the connective tissue that surrounds the peripheral nerve is the epineurium. Here you can see the perineurium. So this is the perineurium. What is perineurium? Around a fasciculus of the axon. Okay, this is the perineurium which is surrounds a fasciculus. Okay, then epineurium means this is the epineurium. It surrounds or the connective tissue that surrounds the peripheral nervous is the epineurium. And endoneurium, the connective tissue that around the axon, it is the endoneurium. Okay, here you can see the nerve fibers which is surrounded by the connective tissue of each axon. It is the endoneurium. This is the perineurium, the connective tissue around a fasciculus of the axon is the perineurium. Then epineurium, the connective tissue around the peripheral nerve is the epineurium. Okay. Next, while coming to the optic nerve. So, optic nerve is very important because it is having a central artery and vein of the retina. It is covered by three layers of meninges. So here you can see bundles of axon fibers. So remember, optic nerve, in optic nerve you can see a central artery and vein of retina. It is surrounded by three layers of the meninges, and you can see bundles of axon fibers. Look at this picture. You can see a central artery and vein. Okay, this is the vein, and here you can see the central retinal artery. It is surrounded by three layers of the meninges: dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater. Okay, so it is pale staining. Then the groups of axon fibers seen in the bundles, and mainly we are focused to the central retinal artery and central vein. So whenever you are focusing this slide through the microscope, you can mention that it is surrounded by three layers of the meninges: dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater, from outer to inner. Dura mater, arachnoid mater, and pia mater, and centrally placed artery, that too retinal artery and retinal vein. Okay, and you can see the groups of fibers, axonal fibers, also seen in bundles. Is it clear? So the optic nerve, what are all the points you will write? It is having centrally placed retinal artery and the vein. It is surrounded by three layers of the meninges: dura mater, then arachnoid mater, and pia mater. You can see the groups of axonal fibers. Okay. Next, while coming to the spinal ganglion, presence of large-sized, round-shaped, pseudo-unipolar neurons. The neurons are centrally placed, and they are having prominent satellite cells around the neuron. Then the neuronal groups are separated by the nerve fibers. Okay, so the spinal ganglion are large size, they are having round shape, and the neurons are centrally placed. Then you can see the satellite cells on each neuron. Then how they are separated? The neuronal groups are separated by the nerve fibers. Okay, here in this diagram you can see the nerve fibers. These are all the nerve fibers in between the neuron. Okay, so this diagram for the spinal ganglion, how they are arranged? They are arranged in the groups, and at the periphery you can see the satellite cells. Okay, satellite cells are seen clearly around the neuronal cell body. Okay, here you can see the myelinated nerve fibers. Okay, is it clear? So next, while coming to the sympathetic ganglion, we already thought about the spinal ganglion. How the spinal ganglion? It is large size, the neuron, then centrally placed nuclei. They are having prominent satellite cells. Okay, here in the sympathetic ganglion, it is made up of multipolar neurons. The neurons are placed eccentrically, and few satellite cells can be seen. How the neurons are arranged? They are not in the groups. They are scattered there and there, and they are not having a particular shape. But in the spinal ganglion, we had seen round neurons. Here in the sympathetic ganglion, the neurons are irregular in shape. Okay, so the sympathetic ganglion, it is made up of multipolar neurons. Nuclei of neurons are placed eccentrically. The satellite cells are few in number. The neurons are scattered, not in the groups. Okay, then the neurons are irregular in shape. Okay, here you can see the multipolar neurons. These are the multipolar neurons. Then you can see the nucleus, where the nucleus is present, not in the center, eccentrically nuclei. Okay, and they are not having a particular shape, they are irregular. But in the spinal ganglion, we had seen that they are arranged in groups or bundles. Here in the sympathetic ganglion, they are scattered, and the nuclei, it is present eccentrically. Okay, then you can see few satellite cells. But in spinal ganglion, we had seen more number of satellite cells while compared to sympathetic nerve fiber. Okay, let us see the types of neuroglia that found in the central and peripheral nervous system. So the neuroglia that present in the nervous system, it is divided into astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, ependymal cells and microglia. Okay, how the neuroglia in the central nervous system is divided? Astrocyte, oligodendrocyte, microglia and ependymal cells. The astrocyte is further divided into protoplasmic astrocyte and fibrous astrocyte. The ependymal cells, it is divided into choroidal epithelium, tanysites and ependymocytes. Okay. The neuroglia in the peripheral nervous system is divided into satellite cells and Schwann cells. There are four types of neuroglial cells. Already we told that astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, microglia and ependyma. Astrocyte is further divided into two types, fibrous astrocytes and protoplasmic astrocyte. So where you can see the fibrous astrocytes, they are found mainly in the white matter. Then what about the protoplasmic astrocyte, where you can see it is found mainly in the gray matter. So what is the function of the astrocyte? They are the primary glycogen storehouse in the brain. They constitute the blood-brain barrier. Okay, so the astrocytes, they are the primary glycogen storehouse in the brain. They constitute the blood-brain barrier. They are further divided into two types, fibrous astrocytes and protoplasmic astrocyte. The fibrous astrocyte, where you can see, they are found mainly in the white matter. Protoplasmic astrocytes, you can see it in the gray matter. Okay, so the neuroglia, they are divided or classified into four types, astrocyte, oligodendrocyte, microglia and ependymal cells. Astrocytes, again they are divided into two types, fibrous astrocytes and protoplasmic astrocyte. Fibrous astrocytes are found mainly in the white matter. Protoplasmic astrocytes are found mainly in the gray matter. Then these astrocytes are the glycogen storehouse in the brain and they constitute the blood-brain barrier. Okay. Then while coming to the oligodendrocytes, they form myelin sheath around the axon in the central nervous system. They myelinate more than one nerve fiber. Okay, the oligodendrocytes forms the myelin sheath around the axon in the central nervous system and they myelinate more than one nerve fiber. Then from where the microglia are derived? They are derived from the white blood cells. So what will be their function? Phagocytosis. Is it clear? So the astrocytes are two types, fibrous astrocytes and protoplasmic. Okay, then they are the glycogen storehouse in the brain and they constitute the blood-brain barrier. Oligodendrocyte forms the myelin sheath around the axon and the central nervous system. They myelinate more than one nerve fiber. Then while coming to the microglia, they are derived from the white blood cells and their function is phagocytosis. Then while coming to the ependymal cells. Ependymal cells means they are the cavity, lines the cavities of the brain and central canal of the spinal cord. They are divided into three groups that line the cells that line the ventricle and the central canal is the ependymocytes. Okay, ependymocytes. Then the cells that line the floor of the third ventricle is the tanysites and covers the choroid plexus is the choroidal epithelial cells. From the term itself, choroidal epithelial cells means covers the choroid plexus. Tanysites means they line the floor of the third ventricle. Ependymocytes means they line the ventricle and the central canal. Is it clear? Ependymal cells means the cells that lines the cavity of the brain and the central canal of the spinal cord. They divided into three groups. The cells that line the ventricle and the central canal is the ependymocytes. The cells that line the floor of the third ventricle is the tanysites and the choroid epithelial cells that covers the choroid plexus. By this, we completed the tissue and its classification. Okay, out of these four tissues, one can expect as a 10 mark question. And difference between three muscles is very important. It can be asked for a short note. Okay, so thank you.